Okay. Check out this one. Everyone's outside. He sounded like the Star Trek theme starting up. Original track.
Is it really necessary for you to drag around all that gear?
Oh, you're being dreadful, darling. Please shut up. No, I don't think so. It's broken. Now that makes me think this place has been taken over. Yeah, as the ominous music begins, this place has been taken over by spacers. And they broke the computer and who knows what else. You're great. Stressed? Management can help. There is no more management. They're all dead. Reminder, safety drill soon. Well, there's not much here. Safety protocol. Remember to follow all decontamination procedures before exiting this area. I'll do my best to keep that in mind. Go see once and for all what kind of personnel this is. This is my skip pack now. Oh, it just says they're colonists. Oh. Should be fine then. Go over and say hello. Oops. I get first dibs. I talk to them first, colonists. Hi.
Howdy.
They're extremely talkative.
Excuse me.
Greetings.
Hey.
They're very terse.
Another person out here.
Oh, it's the captain.
We're completely out of water and could use a spare drink back.
Oh. 3,000 credits? I'm gonna do that. What happened with your supplies?
We just left the homestead when House Varun Zealots attacked us.
Uh-oh.
Ended up having to jettison our cargo just to escape. It's a miracle we even made it out alive. But now we don't have enough to get back home.
Alright, well, here's some water.
Wow. Thanks, stranger. I really appreciate it. I know how hard it is to survive out here. I promise you, we won't let this go to waste.
Why would you do that?
Pardon.
Is that you, Sarah?
Hello.
Oh.
Ahem,
okay. I see some repairs might be needed. What ship is that? Raptor. Med packs. Hippolyta. Advanced lock, okay. Well, I like that whenever there's a ship, you can just take their med packs and just go about your business. Shouldn't you have your pack on? You're just like walking around normally. Did I?
Only one point of Moera's patrol route. Want to see what I'm carrying?
Did I? You have a spacesuit. Why are you not wearing one of your suits?
Okay.
I mean, granted, I'm glad you're not, but by all rights, you should be, like, in agony right now. It's hanging out on his torp here. Storage box. It is mine! What happened? Oh, credits and oh, okay. That's fine. There's the captain again. So we didn't go in here, right? There's a lot of stuff. Nicholas Nickleby. Oh, what? There's another book down there. Simpler Times? I have to say I came across this, but I don't remember, so I'll read it again. My apologies if it's been read. The foreword to a non-fictional account of life in New Homestead, collected from residents over the years, originally published in 2324. Just 300 years, guys, and we'll get to see this book. If anyone tells you, like the title of this book, that life back in the early colonies could be described as simpler times, they're full of it. The title, thusly, is a repudiation of the idea. You'll see the claims in various forms of media, brochures, and other corporatized devices that life was somehow simpler than we have it today. The portrayals in such series as the old family-friendly show Hab on the Ice, for instance, paint an idealized perspective of New Homestead that couldn't be further from the truth. Hab on the Ice. Yeah, maybe. I didn't read this. I don't remember that. Life was never simple here. The people you're about to hear from, some dating back to the mid-2100s, provide a unique insider view into what it was really like on Titan. You'll read about their struggles in the New Frontier era, as well as more current accounts of what it is like to preserve that veneer while dealing with the galaxy that has moved on. Forward by Amalia Segid? Sejed?
Oh, for God's sake. Drop some of that rubbish already.
Shut up back there. You get back out there. You're starting to become a nuisance. Sort of. Do I have these books? I wish I could remember. Let me see. Thank you. I've got it. I had it. I read it. That's my second one. Sword of Damocles we also have. But there was another one. Red Rover, come over. An excerpt from Lubov's songs novel, Red Rover, Come Over, an alternate history where autonomous robotic rovers gained sentience, replicated, and colonized Mars before humans could form colonies. Yeah, I don't remember that. Larissa just smiled. The machine continued to blink its lights and emit faint whines as its servos whirled, unsure of how to proceed. But machine communication was Larissa's specialty. She flicked the buttons on her universal comm unit. Its LEDs blinked rapidly in response to her movements. It's okay, she signaled through the device. I won't hurt you, but if we've any hope of getting out of this cave, we need to work together. Larissa hadn't expected her day to go like this, trapped in a disused mining tunnel under the surface of Mars with a frightened and potentially hostile maintenance robot, but her espionage training had prepared her for similar situations. The machine clicked and beeped in response. I trust you. It wasn't a direct translation. As precise as machine binary language was, there was still a lot of room for misinterpretation when translated to her native tongue. It was close enough. The robot seemed to relax. Its glowing aperture expanded to let more light in as it gazed at her, taking in any information it could glean from her. Then it extended one of its many clamps in her direction. She took hold with a firm yet gentle grip, pulled the small robot out from under the rubble. There we go. That's better, isn't it? She asked, clicking out her message on her comm unit. Now, if you could lead me out of this tunnel and back to my dropship, I can call for backup that could help your fellow machines fight back against your oppressors. The robot seemed to nod in understanding and began to wheel its way down the rocky corridor, stopping every so often to let Larissa catch up. Well, that's pretty cool. I like that. Terabrew coffee. So I got, like, food storage and kitchen area. Red Harvest Pale Ale. Chandra Sauvignon Blanc, with notes of passion fruit and freshly cut grass. Why would anyone want to drink grass? Calibrated ground crew pack. They're so heavy, and that's not as good as what I have. Making yourself at home. It's just it's a take. Full-furled spiced worms. Foodstuffs. Sushi rolls. Zero oil. I think
for God's sake, drop some of that rubbish already.
Don't talk crap about sushi. Any people. Display projector. Tales of Space and Time. and the comet. I'm pretty sure you've seen the comet. Yeah. I didn't want to take it. Tales of Space and Time. Sorry about that. The Crystal Egg. There was, until a year ago, a little and very grimy-looking shop near Seven Dials, over which, in weather-worn yellow lettering, the name of Sea Cave, naturalist and dealer in antiquities, was inscribed. The contents of its window were curiously variegated. They comprised some elephant tusks and an imperfect set of chessmen, beads and weapons, a box of eyes, two skulls of tigers and one human, several moth-eaten stuffed monkeys, one holding a lamp, an old-fashioned cabinet, a fly-blown ostrich egg or so, some fishing tackle, and an extraordinarily dirty, empty glass fish tank. There was also, at the moment the story begins, a mass of crystal worked into the shape of an egg and brilliantly polished. 1899 saw the publication of this collection of H.G. Wells' works, which is comprised of three short stories and two novellas, The Crystal Egg, The Star, The Man Who Could Work Miracles, A Story of the Stone Age, and A Story of the Days to Come. Interesting. So this is like the mess hall? Precious cargo, our lives in your hands. Trauma pack and injector. Just make yourself at home. Oh, it's a Reliant Medical. Fleshy Galactic Cat. History of the Pirates. Oh, this is new. The 1724 work, A General History of the Pirates, is a first-hand account of the lives and adventures of several swashbucklers who plied their trade in the Caribbean during the so-called Golden Age of Piracy. It was supposedly written by one Captain Charles Johnson, but there's no evidence that such a person actually existed. Instead, most people attribute the book to Daniel Defoe, famed author of Robinson Crusoe. Isn't it Robinson Crusoe? I put Robinson. I might be wrong. Writing under a pen name, the following is an excerpt. Chapter 3 of Captain Teach, alias Blackbeard. Edward Teach was a Bristol man born, but had sailed some time out of Jamaica in privateers in the late French War, yet though he had often distinguished himself for his uncommon boldness and personal courage, he was never raised to any command till he went a-pirating, which I think was at the latter end of the year 1716, when Captain Benjamin Hornigold put him into a sloop that he had made prize of, and with whom he continued in consortship till a little while before Hornigold surrendered. In the spring of the year 1717, Teach and Hornigold sailed from Providence for the main of America and took in their way a billup from the Havana with 120 barrels of flour, as also a sloop from Bermuda, third bar master, from whom they took only some gallons of wine and then let him go, and a ship from Madeira to South Carolina, out of which they got plunder to a considerable value. After cleaning on the coast of Virginia, they returned to the West Indies, and in the latitude of 24 made prize of a large French Guinea man bound to Martinigo, which by Hornigold's consent, Teach went aboard as captain and took a cruise in her. Hornigold returned with his sloop to Providence, where, at the arrival of Captain Rogers, the governor, he surrendered to mercy, pursuant to the king's proclamation. One thing sure about old books, they really don't know how to end a sentence. You got all these semicolons that could be in all separate sentences there. Muzzle and me. And I can't read that. Some kind of credits. Whoever made the film. Just notebooks. What's that? What's this tablet? Oh, it's an advanced lock for the safe here. Positron battery. It says it's rare, so I grab it. Return of the Interceptor, coming this fall. From the studio that brought you the Interceptor. Yeah, it makes sense. I don't think I can pick this, but why not? Give it a try. I've yet to do an advanced lock. And we can't even do this with this. Yeah, I'm gonna give up on that. I don't think we can get that one. It's dark in here. Flip on the breakers. Oh yeah, everyone outside, no one's inside.
You need to get rid of some of that gear.
I can't give it to you. You're full. Oh, this is where we've been. Synergy. There's no I in synergy. That's true. Status. Movie night in the lounge. Yes, no. Looks like the yes is one. So we came from there, right? We go down and we go this way. Did you pick? Yay! I already have a Chunks employee handbook. Now, how do I get... in here? Because this... Oh, that's outside. Oh, okay. That's outside too? Okay. It's so dark, I thought there were other rooms in there. And I came from here. Maybe not. Propellant for times that you only need one propellant. I just wanted a antimicrobial notepad on top of a notebook. They'll both blink. Get out of here again. That's another safe. Let's see if she'll put her suit on. She won't even come out. Yeah, she got a suit on. Yay! Oops. Jump over that. Got stuck, so... Okay, so I've been in there. I've been all around here. I just haven't been over there.
Slowing down.
I know. I'm gonna sell it. This might not be something we can go inside. I don't think so. Maybe up there. Can we go up there? No, not yet anyway. Up there. Grab it. Ugh. Anyone credits. Here we go. Frontier's over there. And somewhere past it is another thing. It's not going to let me fast travel there because I'm carrying too much. So off screen I will do that. And I'll probably go dock with that space station that orbits the other moon? I forget what. Nova Galactic Star Yard. Well, I don't remember it being called that. That's where we are now, right, Titan? It's a Deimos Star Yard, right? Orbiting Mars. So, yeah, I might just run back there and see what of these things can be explored. I mean, really, this is our own solar system. We shouldn't have unknown. We should know it all. Like, how could we, in this day and age, not know of the magnetosphere of Saturn? We should know everything there is to know about Saturn, except for a first-hand experience of enduring that environment, which probably take about less than a second to die. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. I'm gonna take care of this stuff, and I'll meet you back. We definitely want to explore that other structure here before continuing on elsewhere. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.